Hello, masterminds. Happy 420. It's finally the ultimate green day of our lives. That means it's time to get high and feel, think, and act in many ways. 420. April 20th and April 2020. It may be 420 this entire month of this year, but I haven't gotten high in a long time, so I intend for a one and done today, so that I don't accelerate me going insane, especially in lockdown. Long-term induced munchies and anxiety would be problematic.
It's cloudy outside, so that means I get to record early today. Yay.
I still have edibles, but I'm just gonna smoke today. It's all cloudy inside now. My awesome as fuck blue replica in standard tuning. So strange. Mwah. Mwah.
originally intended to play that Green Day song today, but I feel in the mood to play some more Green Day music. I feel good, you know? And I don't think I'm going to share these on Instagram, so this is, this part is, YouTube exclusive. Even if I mess up. Thank you.
what you're thinking. Well, I toss and turn all night thinking of your ways of affection, but to find that it's not different at all. Well, I throw away my past mistakes and contemplate my future. That's when I say, what the heck?
I tuned my guitar a half a step down. Now it's time for Kerplunk songs.
Staring out of my window, watching the cars go rolling by. My friends are gone, I've got nothing to do. So I sit here patiently, watching the clock tick so slowly. Gotta get away, all my friends will explode. Give me something to do to kill some. Thank you. Was I
moments later.
Thank you.
Before I end the vlog, Masterminds, I want to share with you how I rank Green Day studio albums from best to worst. Pardon my, my voice, because I just had an avocado shake and it's making it difficult to speak. Very sticky. Anyway. Number 1, American Idiot. 2, Dookie. 3, 21st Century Breakdown. 4, Insomniac. 5, Revolution Radio. 6, Kerplunk. 7, 39 Smooth. 8, Nimrod. 9, Warning. 10, Uno. 11, Father of All Motherfuckers. 12, Trey. And 13, Dose. Sound slash production value is low on my list of determining factors for albums ranked 1 through 5. I consider them high in social purpose. They are anthems. Artistic anthems. Misery was made into fun, and punk went beyond its calling. 39 Smooth and Kerplunk are the base of Green Day. They are the blueprint of a fountain of youth. Yeah. I find Kerplunk more tasteful than 39 Smooth because in the lyric department, it's more forward-thinking. The albums ranked 8 through 13 are the experimental records of Green Day. The dynamic at play that I see in them is purpose driven by lyrics versus musicianship. So how layered is the sound? You know, acoustic with electric, for instance. Versus quantity of content. Those albums just have a more overt disconnect between punk, the ethos, and punk, the sound. Regarding FOMF versus the trilogy albums, I still think FOMF is better than the trilogy altogether. If the best of the trilogy were in one album, then FOMF would be at the bottom. Uno has the least filler and is most representative of the garage punk sound. And I just find Trey sluggish to get through. I like the album though. Dose just leaves me feeling empty. FOMF is a weak Green Day album, but it doesn't overstay its welcome. With that said, Masterminds, you may see me earlier, but expect me on May 1st. Alright? Alright. Thank you very much for watching. Remember, be smart for your heart and stay safe. Good night.